An audio.
On TV.
Popping is at
ready for the first of the qualifying heats for the Cup. Stages in the race, but the Volvo, the 1:28 Volvo, is leading the field. That's Paul Atkins. Closing down is Needy Peck in hot pursuit as the cars begin to schedule themselves around the circuit. So 1:28 with 3:03. Mark Atkins in the 1:28 car spins around, loses his second place. 303 car still in there. Jason Oliver is in the lead position now. And there he goes up on the inside. And this is only a heat. 22 car then, Dave Hendrickson. Not the most elaborate paintwork we've seen. Whoa! We've got action on all four turns at the Coventry Stadium now. Dave Vincent still not being compromised at all down the back straightaway. Here comes the flag, it's the 22 car, Dave Vincent. Gentlemen, in with a win tonight, the first of our winners in the Unlimited Coventry Masters, Dave Vincent right here. Give him a round of applause. Up on the rostrum, Dave, it's all yours. So thanks to our sponsors, Dave gets the photo call with our Coventry girls. So he gets the trophy, the wrecking bars, and the sledgehammer. That's not bad for winning a race.
That's it.
not bad at all.
Rushing you through that one, and took your opportunity in the early to spin out, and you were there.
Yeah, it's the best thing to spin him out, really.
Of course it is, that's the name of the game. So your car looks intact, not a problem there, not exactly the most elaborate paintwork, but who cares, it's a quick motor. Your eyes are on the final, that title.
That'd be nice, yeah. So I've come second a couple of times, but I'd love to win it.
Where are you from, Dave?
Near Milton.
All right, not exactly home, but now all those are yours, mate, so we'll try and get them over to you. You come and get them over, right, okay. That's the American, what we think is to a Chrysler in a spot above her. 62 then, out there on the field, or 67, Mark Whitaker. The 82 Volvo with a puff of smoke coming outside from Frankie Donnelly. More than his fair share of steam and smoke coming out there on the infield, the green Volvo estate. Whoa, he really takes him out there. So Mark Whitaker then in the 67 car. Finger over to Mark Whitaker just as soon as we can. Yeah. Lovely. Well done, Ricky. Good win, mate.
Thanks very much, mate. Yeah, gone off the front and just kept foot down.
And the car's still intact, and that is a classic car.
That is, I hope so.
We hope it's lucky for you. You got this. You got your sledgehammer. See? The sort of car Her Majesty the Queen used to drive, but not that one. Themselves out as they get into the first couple of corners under racing conditions. Speaking in the 318 car, quickly to get through into second place. 4-3-1 reading, there comes Speaky. 318 is taking the lead. It gets a bit of a shove from the 4-3-1 car. Two on eight is Rob Speak, former former world champion Formula One and Formula Two stock car racing, and Rob is a keen competitor in Unlimited Bangers. And there he is, just crossing the line, 218, Rob Speak. But 318, another member of the Speak family, can we Rob Speak, is still in lead position. Whoa! And now where's the Yank tank going? It's not the DD yet. In the American car is doing, we really don't know, because this is not the DD. This is the third qualifying heat, and we've got a bit of tactics going on there as 318 goes three laps next time. Three laps. The 318 car still in the lead, and a bit of engines going on between the green Chevy and the 218 car of Rob Speak, who's lost a lot of ground there. And the American car is really not understanding the rules of this qualifier at all. He's waiting for Speaky, I think. The 218 car, the silver car, and there goes the American 1-2 team. But oh, he missed him. How did he miss that? Oh, he's missed him again. Now this was the DD. And now the raceman has got him. He's burying him. The Speak family fight back. Oh, they're all having a go at Wilf. Boy, oh boy. And this is a qualifying heat. You wait for the DD.
Do that.
He's up on the rostrum, Wilf Speak. Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. He hates being interviewed. Not like Rob, are you? Was that a vengeance going on there? Because I see you going into the American. No, of course you didn't, no. Simon gives them the yellows, Nick Stiles has yellows, that'll turn to green, and then we're racing for real. Kyle Shires in the 01 car then, right around the outside to take the lead as they begin to nudge and spin their way around. A lot of action going on. There's the Stickbridge 04 car out of it. That's Mike Croft. As the race rolls on. That's our American car nudged out of the way. Oh, he's still running. We'll get back into it, hopefully. Kyle Shires in the 01 car in race lead position. Now we get the reds going out there. As we can see, a bit of a couple of buried cars up in the safety fence around the scoreboard. Ooh, a couple of nice spins out there on the city turn of the stadium. A bit of smoke as well as the green Volvo. Whoa! The Yank went following in rather nicely there as he has to pull out, having done the damage. Not too good on his own car, I'm afraid. So still Kyle Shires in lead position in the 01 car. It's the 1-2-3 behind Kyle as they go down the back straightaway.
Oh,
4-5-1, who wins the last chance consolation. He books his place in the Coventry Masters final. Jogging them around now, as we do. And as I say, by being early on the track doesn't necessarily guarantee a pole position. We do that to mix it up to give everybody a fair chance. Attack there, the 137 car, Spanner. A familiar with starter, Nick Stiles, is confident they're all under power. Richie is, and this is the Coventry Masters. We're away and running. 154, taking an early lead there. Nick Plant. So 154. And now we've got some action down on the home straight away as they more or less block the whole of the racing circuit. The 154 manages to stay clear of that. He's through and holding an impressive lead at this moment, but still make up. And they're really going for broke in this one. Bang! Sideways in into the city turn. We're sorting out the men from boys now. Woo-hoo. 22 car out of action, facing the wrong way, as gets caught as well as the race roars on. 154, Nick Plant. And quite a few early retirements, and it's the Mark 10 Jag. All the shot car spares slowly cruises around the stadium centre. The bear's being pushed. Stinkbridge has none of that, pushes him out of the way. So bears versus Stinkbridge there. New leader. 362 is our race leader. Then in the green and white Volvo Estate. But still a lot of laps to go in this Coventry Masters final. Will he be caught? Could be. Completely taken away out of the lead position now, so it changes hands again. So Ricky Beasley then. Ricky Beasley, who we saw on the rostrum in that Mark 1 Granada Coupe, is achieving his dream. He's holding the pole position in lead. P1 position then for Ricky Beasley. Staying well out of trouble as well as we follow him around. A bit of a nudge there. Ooh, and another Volvo from the Bears spins away. Into the second section of this race on the halfway staging, so 15 laps in total. Now we're into lap number 11 with Ricky Beasley in the 67 car. And we've got one of the cars up on its side there on the scoreboard end of the along come the reds. Out come the red flags, on come the red stoplights. A car down inside the rescue squad about to run over side of Benyon's first there, so we bring them down to a halt. 67 car is in the lead position. That's not one you play. John Golden in 384 is second, but there is your lead. There's your leader then. 67 car is in lead position. Off go the reds, on come the yellows. Now before Nick has charged away, change the flags, they're racing. Conrad Masters re-racing again. Here we go. Ricky Beasley then in the 67 car. 384 getting a bit of pressure from 617. And just two laps to go now is when Ricky Beasley crosses the line. He's breathing fresh air. 617 getting sideways there. Up on the tarmac, back onto the shale. So the 67 car then of Ricky Beasley. Whoops. One lap to go for Ricky in the 67 car. He looks like last year's champion Jack Obrey is in the runner-up position at the moment. He's lost his crown, he's lost his title, because the 2010 Coventry Unlimited Bangers champion is there, 67 Ricky Beasley. The trophy is yours. There you go. Plus the locking tool chest for your vehicle, one of your vehicles. Plus the crowbars, plus the beer, plus the sledgehammer, and plus two nights out with Jeremy Heaver. Oh, who said that? We'll wait for them to turn to green, and then we get racing for the Unlimited Mango All-Covers race. Oh, and they started already.
Speaking
of the train there down the top turn. And he's reversed backwards into them, so the Bears gets a bit of the action there as the race rolls on. 9.98, Connie Jr. then, your race leader. There's the leader just crossing the line there, 9.98 at the back, Jack. Ooh, what a nice spin there. Leaves the Bears high and dry. There you go. Three laps left of this time as 9.98 crosses the line. Three laps left. Connie Jr. then. It is Jag is out in the clear. And a serious amount of bent tin around the top end. Mini DD, I think, here. One lap to go, is that? One lap to go, and Ronnie Jr. gets his wheels in line. 24 in second place. That's Morris for second, doing well. That's Randy for second, I'm afraid. Women of everywhere. In the nick of time then, Coventry Junior takes the win in the 518 car. And I think we've got our own DD, which Brown has, just because they can. Oh, yes! Bang! Well, we did try to tell the drivers the DD is a separate race, but I don't think they listened, because we're seeing it right now. The reds are on, but... Yeah, but it was won by 9.98, Connie Jr. So he gets the all-comers trophy, plus the sledgehammer and the crowbars as well.
Straight away now.
Springs out the 44 car. Three 60 car takes a pass from 46. The Volvo estate spins round. The 3-7 still running. Missed him. Oh, Jack's still going. Look, there she is. Oh, we lost a lot of water. Here we go. Top. Lifted him higher. Drive. Oh, follow him. And again. So, nice bit of a mini train going on there. We think the plans are okay. Three main cars still. Four now. Five now. Still running. Is it still? Bang! 46 running. So 46 is up the power, the Jag is still going. The 2-6 car, the Jag. That's Keith Reynolds. Keith Reynolds in the Jag, still operational. Couple of moves. Bang! Nice one. Got the power in for that, yeah. And a bit of smoke. Yeah, well done, Keith. He wrecks the Jag, but good hit. The 3-litre, the 360 car. Oh. Is he dead? Is it over? Is the Supra still going to go? I wonder, how do we determine or let the Simon to adjudicate on that one for us? For the
of Jack Reynolds. So, that's our final race of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Boxing tomorrow at 1 o'clock. That's the World Championships. Right, 46 then, Scott. Scott McDonald, so Jack comes up from the 360 car. There he is.
Love and death.